Ladies and gentlemen, the Bethlehem Area School District Administration, Board of Directors, and the Freedom High School Administration, faculty, and staff. And now the Freedom High School Fife and Drum Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with distinct honor to present to you the valedictorian for the class of 2023, Arun Chugani. Thank you. And now, presenting the Freedom High School graduating class of 2023.
Good evening. At this time, I ask that you remain standing. Gentlemen, please remove your hats for the playing, singing, and signing of the national anthem and Freedom's alma mater. Good evening, everyone. My name is Laurie Sage, and I am the principal of Freedom High School, and I welcome you to this wonderful event. Class of 2023, you have never looked better than tonight. Everyone. Every graduate sitting on the floor tonight has an individual journey that has gotten him or her to this milestone achievement. Tonight is the time to celebrate and recognize each one of you for the 13 years of schooling with an eye on your past 4 years at Freedom. I look forward to a distinguished event where all family members and guests present can be witness to their graduates' accomplishments. Additionally, we are streaming our graduation ceremony live. Thus, I welcome our guests watching us in the other parts of this state, the country, and overseas. I hope you enjoy this evening. I turn it over to Mrs. Volpato and our choir at this time. He has very specific instructions to not seat until the last person gets back to their seat. So thank you, Brigitte. This year we have three student speakers, and together they chose the theme, Dreamer, Builder, Explorer. It's my honor to present the class selected speaker, Gerald Veneracion.
Mr. Fascinetto, Dr. Roy, members of the Board of School Directors, Ms. Sage, platform guests, faculty members, parents and friends, and fellow members of the class of 2023. This day feels like a dream to me, as if I were still in first grade, failing to properly kick that kickball we'd use during recess. Back when we used to treat kickball as if we were being scouted by LSU or Duke. Or the moment when we tried to make the cut for the fifth grade track meet, only to witness Asa Packer demolish all of us in almost every single event. That was 7 years ago, when each moment within our childhood was fueled with inspiration, determination, and curiosity from the world around us. A part of me still kept that childish trait, one which the youth will always carry, and that's the trait of being idealistic. Chasing dreams that may seem different or irrational, but used to fuel our ambition for a future that gives us purpose. That's the trait of the human spirit. The ambition and drive to accomplish the obligations and passions we look toward every single day has been breathtaking, and by far one of the longest journeys the class of 2023 has taken. From the long nights we used to stay up to study for exams, to the day where we expressed our knowledge of that course in a form of a test. From the long nights that the Freedom High School Theater Company spent, memorizing line after line, the band, orchestra, and choir, memorizing note after note, to showing a room filled with people the capabilities of their talent in the form of art. From long hours spent by athletes training through pain and having the mental fortitude to become better, to the day you showed the spectators and your competitors your athletic capabilities. From the nights that we would wonder who we were or what was next, to the day where we could appreciate ourselves and the goals we would set for the future. Even if it was just to get through another school day, to being present here at your graduation, knowing that you've made it through 4 long years of high school. This is what the journey looked like for the class of 2023, to embody an idea of what interested us and letting our ambitions be fueled by our dreams and lead us to a path of success. Every single member of the class of 2023 should be proud of these accomplishments, because none of your accomplishments come without the presence of commitment and hard work. We are all different in nature and perceive our paths to be different in so many ways, which is why the extent and reason for our accomplishments differ. Yet, we are all akin to the notion of what success looks like, and what drives our future endeavors is the same no matter what type of person we may be. We all share the need to satisfy our desires. We are all dreamers alike in a sense that our lives are filled with our own goals and aspirations. What separates us from each other is the extent to which we are willing to foster that dream into reality. For my brother, it was the dream of going through I-95 without traffic. And although I'll tell him to keep dreaming, he spent 6+ hours driving here in order to support me on this occasion today. A former Freedom High School graduate. Yes, give him a round of applause. Yes. A former Freedom High School graduate and a true role model in my life, I wanted to thank him and my family for always supporting me and being a huge influence on my life. I also wanted to thank the rest of the audience for being present here today in support of the class of 2023. Your support is impactful for these students, so give yourselves a round of applause. Our dreams are not only fueled by the ambition, by our own ambition, but the people around us want to see it come to fruition. This is why we're all sitting here today, in recognition for the achievements we've accumulated by each graduating student. We should also recognize the diversity and differences that come within the class of 2023. We are all unique and ambitious with the way we want to envision our future. It's athletes such as Aaron Levy, who has always had the passion for basketball, that drives his ambition. I've known him since elementary school, and he has always been a true inspiration to me to persevere and commit to the things that matter most to me. Thank you, Aaron. It's people in theater, such as Allison McCullough, who never falls short in achieving the things she wants to achieve in her life and will continue to do so by pursuing her passion in theater. Thank you, Allison. It's first responders such as Nathaniel Lambert, who drives his ambition through pursuing a selfless career. Yes, give him a round of applause. Nathaniel Lambert drives his ambition through pursuing a selfless career path in hopes to help out others in need. It's brave souls such as Sven Orcheski, who takes pride and passion in being a Marine. Round of applause for Sven. Sven Orcheski takes pride and passion in being a Marine, heading into the military, which contributed to the roots of this country and our freedom. It's also the woman in STEM, people such as Caitlin Guider and Sarah LaRiviere, who contribute. Yes, give them a round of applause as well. They contribute to a generation of women who don't conform to what society wants them to be, but most importantly, to have equal opportunity to have bigger ambitions. That's the world I dream of, a world in which my peers and I can fulfill our dreams and chase a life that is meaningful for ourselves. Society cannot take that away from us. Just like how no one can show us what to dream of when we sleep, we're the only ones responsible for the life we live after high school. However, just like any other dream, we cannot neglect the nightmares that will exist. Nightmares such as failure, which we are often afraid of. Yet just like any other dream, we know that nightmares do not last forever, and we can embrace those failures in order to better ourselves. The goals we will set and the achievements we will obtain, as well as the struggles we will face, those are for each of us to experience individually. We will embrace both the dreams we foster in our lives, as well as the nightmares we'll endure. That is what it means to be a human being. To be present and aware of every single day and to live through it, no matter the arduous struggle presented by a nightmare or the tranquility presented by a peaceful dream. So let's live through a day as high schoolers for the last time. And as you walk on the stage and accept your diploma, I want you to never forget who you are and the reason behind why you choose to dream for the life ahead of you. Never forget the human spirit of idealism and use it to fuel your ambitions for a future and dream or make your dreams into reality. And finally, never forget this moment, the moment when you come up on this stage and accept your diploma. Let it be a gentle reminder of your perseverance, hard work, and growth over the last 4 years. Be proud of it, because we are not done dreaming yet as we build a new chapter of our lives, which we will explore. To each graduating student of the class of 2023, you will do amazing things in this world. So let's show this world what it means to dream.
Thank you so much, Jay Rold. The class selected speaker, excuse me, the faculty selected speaker, Lauren Humphrey.
Mr. Fascinetto, Dr. Roy, members of the Board of School Directors, Ms. Sage, platform guests, faculty members, parents and friends, and fellow members of the class of 2023. It is truly an honor to share this momentous day with all of you. Today is a day of immense pride and joy, not only for the graduates, but for everyone in attendance. The class of 2023 will soon walk across this stage and receive our diplomas to commemorate a journey that has spanned 13 years. But this achievement is not solely ours to claim. It took an entire village, our support systems, to reach this point. The incredible Freedom faculty, our loving families, and our unforgettable classmates have supported and built us into the individuals we are today. To our Freedom faculty, you have been the architects building the framework that has empowered us to grow academically, artistically, and athletically. From the lively discussions in the classroom, to the harmonious melodies of the band and orchestra, and the grit displayed on the fields by the athletes. These experiences have enriched our high school years and provided us with opportunities for academic and personal growth. You have not only equipped us with knowledge and skills, but have also encouraged us to take risks, push beyond our limits, and discover our true potential. I am confident that every single member of the class of 2023 sitting before me today can think of a faculty member who has made a significant impact on their lives. For me, the list is long, but I would like to give a special thank you to Mrs. Bayardi, Ms. DiCarlo, Coach Duddy, Mr. Dunstan, Ms. Gilmartin, Ms. Costales, Ms. Sheets, and last but certainly not least, Ms. Sage. All of these wonderful individuals have shaped me in ways that words will never adequately convey the gratitude and awe that I hold in my heart for each of them. On behalf of the entire class of 2023, thank you for being our educators, mentors, coaches, and trusted confidants. We will forever be grateful for your support, tireless efforts, and your extraordinary commitment to our education. To our parents, guardians, and families, you have been the foundation that consistently supports our dreams and aspirations. Thank you for your unconditional love, dedication, and sacrifices. From the countless sleepless nights you spent tending to our needs as infants, to the nurturing and guidance you have provided as we navigated the ups and downs of adolescence, you have been our constant pillars of strength. Throughout the years, you have attended our performances, cheered from the sidelines at our games, and encouraged us to pursue our interests with passion and determination. Thank you for being our greatest support system. As I stand before you today, I know that I owe an immeasurable debt of gratitude to my parents, my three siblings, Elijah, Isaiah, and Mark, and all of my family members who came to share this special moment with me today. Parents, guardians, and families, we could not have done it without you. Finally, to my fellow graduates, we have embraced the spirit of building, creating, and shaping our futures. When we first stepped foot into kindergarten 13 years ago, we did not fully grasp the magnitude of the years that lay ahead. We were young, filled with curiosity, and eager to explore the world around us. I vividly remember when we played with colorful building blocks and Legos and entered the adventurous realms of Minecraft. Little did we know, we were preparing for a journey filled with construction and transformation. We have honed our skills, not only in creating physical structures, but also in building relationships. We have cried together, laughed together, and supported each other through the highs and lows of these last 4 years. Let us carry the memories we have created, the lessons we have learned, and the friendships we have formed as we step into the next phase of our lives. I would like to thank Megan Ruffino, Jasnelle Florian, Christian Marat, Eli Rodriguez, and everyone I have met throughout this journey. Collectively, all of us have played an integral role in making our high school experiences unforgettable. Class of 2023, as we prepare to leave freedom's familiar landscape and explore the world that awaits us, let us remember that we are builders, and our journey of building is far from over. Just as we did not reach this milestone alone, we cannot build our futures in isolation. The strength that we have drawn from one another and the support we have received from our Freedom faculty, families, and friends will continue to guide us forward. When you leave here today, venture out into the world and build. Build with purpose, build with passion, and build with the unwavering belief that you have the power to take on the world. Congratulations, class of 2023. Our journey has just begun. Thank you.
Thank you to J-Rold and Lauren, and Prajit is to come. It is not easy to stand up here and speak in front of this many people, and they have done an absolutely amazing job. All right. Mr. Facinetto, Dr. Roy, members of the Board of School Directors, platform guests, faculty members, parents, friends, and members of the class of 2023. I take great pride in welcoming you to the commencement ceremony for the class of 2023. We have many district representatives here to honor and congratulate our graduates. On stage, we have Mr. Michael Facinetto, School Board President, and Dr. Joseph Roy, Superintendent of Schools. In seats of honor, we have the following school district board members: Mrs. Shannon Patrick, Mr. Winston Alozi, Dr. Dean Donaher, Mr. Michael Rusciutti, and Dr. Sheila White. Joining those school board members are the following members of Bethlehem Central Administration: Dr. Jack Silva, Assistant Superintendent for Education and Chief Academic Officer; Mrs. Claire Hogan, Chief Pupil Services Officer; Mrs. Lee Keeney Rusnak, Director of Special Education; Mrs. Tracy Herner, Director of Student Services; Dr. Benita Draper, Director of Equity Initiatives; Mr. Eric Fontenez, Supervisor of Equity Initiatives; Mr. Mark James, Supervisor of Professional Learning and Technology Integration; Mr. Jose Sanchez, Supervisor of English Learner Services; Dr. Maureen Leeson, Supervisor for Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics; Dr. Joe Anthus, Supervisor of Related Arts and Social Studies; and Mr. Michael Galler, Supervisor of Career and Technical Programs at the Bethlehem Area Vocational Technical School. Located throughout the arena tonight, some on stage and some near the tunnels, are Freedom's assistant principals, Mrs. Robin Alozi, Mr. Michael DeBilio, Mr. Mark Sawicki, Mrs. Amanda Miranda, Ms. Charmaine Aguilar, and Mr. Nathan Stannard, athletic director. I have a few people I need to thank as we begin this evening. I want to thank Mr. Brendan Burke, who is our librarian and technology specialist at Freedom. He is back here. He put an immense amount of time into this new slideshow that we are going to present this evening. Our senior class advisors are Mrs. Annie Schutzler and Mrs. Peg Steckel. Thank you for your work to get the class to this point. I want to thank Mr. Mike Moran, Andrew Lynn, and Jen Volpato for leading the musicians and singers here tonight. I want to thank Mr. Joe Stellato and Mr. Mike Cleffey for their overall organization of the graduates, both during the practices and this evening. And finally, I need to thank my two secretaries, Mrs. Joanne Kilpatrick and Ms. Caroline Nelson, who literally run this evening. They tell me what to do and when, and I do it, and I listen to them. I want to take a moment to welcome and recognize our valedictorian, Arun Chagani. Please stand, Arun. Arun finished with just over a 5.0 GPA. He will be attending. He will be attending the University of Pennsylvania, and he will major in neuroscience. Next, in the seats of honor, directly next to the graduates on the floor, are the teachers and counselors of Freedom High School. Teachers and counselors, you are the reason many of these students are here today. You are the backbone of our school. You are the light during times of darkness. You are the source of so much of the pride I have in working at Freedom. I am going to ask the teachers and counselors to stand and be recognized for their contributions to the class of 2023. Thank you. Freedom also has three retirees this year, teacher David Kleist, teaching assistant Perry Emig, and secretary Joyce Rose. You have been longstanding members of Freedom family, and we will miss you. Last, I need to take a moment to recognize two additional and very special people who are retiring. One is Mr. Russ Giordano, Chief Human Resource Officer, who has been a champion of students and teachers in the BASD for over a decade. He is unable to join us tonight, but I am very thankful for his leadership. Second is Dr. Joseph Roy, Superintendent of Schools. Dr. Roy has been a leader in the fight for equity for all students, and we thank you for your unwavering support of our kids. The Freedom community thanks you for your dedication and service to the students of Bethlehem. You will be missed, Dr. Roy. And to continue with the theme chosen by our three students, as Carolyn Haywood said, children are not only innocent and curious, they are optimistic and joyful and essentially happy. They are, in short, everything us adults wish they could be. Dear graduates, 18 years ago your journey began. You looked at every inch of this world with such wonder. Trees were fortresses that protected you from your enemies. Playgrounds were obstacle courses that could occupy you for hours. Dandelions were beautiful flowers that you gave to your mom or your friend. The world was full of wonder and magic, and you could see it because you looked for it and you believed in it. Sports were fun, they were crazy. Youth soccer, 10 little kids just chasing a ball. T-ball, equal parts swinging a bat and picking weeds while you laid in the grass. Scores didn't matter, ice cream afterwards did. When there was music, you sang loudly, freely, without worry of judgment. Your days at school consisted of sight words and then word problems and time spent with those specialists. You came home exhausted every day because you used every ounce of energy to hold it together in front of your teacher. But your dreams, they were big. Maybe you'd be the Tooth Fairy, or an NBA star, or President of the United States. But it wasn't all rosy. You cried often, maybe when you took a hard fall, or someone was unkind to you, or when you couldn't have ice pops for breakfast. But those tears were dried quickly by hugs or Band-Aids or general rationalization. This part of your journey was innocent and magical. All right, same. Thank you for the enthusiasm. Keep me going here. And just like that, those wistful, carefree days made way for your middle and high school years. The tenor changed from daily recess to algebra and U.S. history, PSSAs, SATs. A sense of ease led way to a sense of awkwardness. Questions changed from, can you come to my birthday party, to, so what are you going to do when you graduate? Practice time for your instrument, your team, or the musical suddenly went from once a week to every single day. The stakes got higher, not all at once, but in a sneaky way, and suddenly all parts of your life began building towards your future. The tears you cried were not so simple anymore. They were the result of broken friendships, or your first broken heart, a failing grade, or a championship loss. The sadness was not so easily mended by ice cream, only through time, a friend's open arms, or the support of your family. But it was during your years here that you were building towards your future. The art classes you took for fun suddenly became the place you found an escape and then ignited a passion. Those games you played against a middle school moved to more intense competition at the varsity level and eventually to a sport you can't live without. The rotations you began in at Votech turned into a job you now worked every summer, which has now become your permanent employer. What you've endured and built throughout the past 18 years is a foundation to be proud of. The first pages of a novel that will be the start of your story. No matter what route it took you to get here, this part of your journey has laid the foundation for what is to come. And now's the hard part. It's time for you to move on. To explore the world beyond the walls that have provided you comfort for so many years. And so tonight, dear graduates, we send you off into the world to explore your wishes to become a musician or a doctor, an actress or a police officer, to continue working that job you balanced for the past few years along with your schoolwork in hopes of becoming a manager, to become an electrician or a teacher or a broadcaster, and for a select few, you are about to report to boot camp in a few short weeks. Some of you will explore other parts of the state, of the country, or of the world. Some of you will stay right here in this wonderful city. But no matter what you do when you leave here tonight, you will take the culmination of your dreaming and building to pursue and explore life beyond the walls of freedom. Tonight, if I had to bet, the majority of the tears are not coming from you, dear graduates. They are coming from your parents and your families who have been with you every step of the past 18 years. Graduates, I ask you to please remember them tonight. Thank your family for sacrificing every part of themselves for you. Hug them tightly before they watch you leave to be with your friends. Because remember, all of the dreaming, the building, and exploring that you've done, your parents and families have been there to support you, and whether you have realized it or not, your journey has always been theirs. So now I leave you to follow those early dreams. I leave you to build the life you desire. I leave you to go explore what this world has to offer you. But whenever you return home, you remember your Freedom family will welcome you back with open arms. Dr. Roy, it gives me great pleasure to certify to you that the members of the Freedom High School class of 2023 have satisfied all academic requirements necessary to graduate from a high school in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
Thank you, Ms. Sage, and thank you for the wonderful job you do here. Your second year, you've brought Freedom to new heights, and I'd like to give Ms. Sage a round of applause. So I entered this superintendency in Bethlehem the year that this class, that you guys and gals, entered kindergarten 13 years ago. And I'm really honored to close out my career with tonight's graduates after those 13 years. This is your one high school graduation. I think it's about my 43rd high school graduation I've been on the stage for as a principal or as a superintendent. But it still means a lot to me because it's the last. And I think I feel the same way and want to recognize the feelings that I hopefully our students, our graduates are feeling as well. Certainly excitement, certainly anxiety about what might lie next. Some people have plans locked in. Some people aren't so sure of what's next. But I hope the overwhelming feeling that our students, graduates, that you feel is gratitude, thankfulness. Gratitude to all the folks that have helped you get to this point. Your parents, your family, your friends, your teachers, your coaches, your principals. I share that same gratitude. I can't do my job without great teachers and principals. We have the best, I always tell other superintendents, the Bethlehem parents are the best parents there are. You are smart, you're reasonable, and you appreciate this big, diverse, sometimes crazy culture that we have in the Bethlehem area school district. And I appreciate that support and you valuing what we do as a public school. So I have great gratitude for our parents and for our community members as well. Quick note, in 13 years, I was officially deemed a meteorologist for watching a lot of snow. Seniors, I gifted you 60 snow days over your careers, all right? Not enough, I know. You may not remember, but you had the most snow days in third grade. We had 10 days of snow days. In ninth grade, you had zero snow days, but that was 1920, so we didn't even have the fourth marking period, so we kind of made up for it there. But while you were learning and moving through your careers, I got to see you grow, and I got to see you take on the amazing community service, the academics, our musical productions, our athletic productions. I saw you grow for 13 years, and I'm so proud of you, and I'm so proud that my last graduation will be your high school graduation. So let's get on with the graduating part. Mr. Fascinetto, President of the Board of School Directors of the Bethlehem Area School District, under the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania in my role as Superintendent of Schools, I hereby certify that these seniors have fulfilled all graduation requirements established by the Bethlehem Area School District and therefore are eligible to receive their high school diplomas this evening. Mr. Fascinetto, the class of 2023.
Good evening, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, faculty, and most importantly, the incredible class of 2023. It is with great honor and pride that I stand before you as the President of the Board of School Directors, and on behalf of the entire board, I want to extend a warm welcome to each and every one of you gathered here to celebrate this momentous occasion, your high school graduation. Graduates, please join me once again in recognizing and thanking your amazing teachers, counselors, principals, hands down, the best professional staff in the Lehigh Valley. You would not be here tonight if not for their dedication to your success. You know, the job of a principal, the job of a teacher, the job of a counselor is not easy. The hours never end, the work is difficult, and sometimes they believed in you even when you didn't believe in yourself. When you were ready to give up, they were that voice behind you, that hand on your back pushing, saying, no, keep going, keep pushing forward. They live and breathe freedom for one reason, and that's tonight, to see you walk across this stage as graduates of the class of 2023. Now, before we begin, I tried this last night at the other school and it worked well. Ms. Sage gets nervous when I talk, Dr. Roy gets nervous when I talk, so I let ChatGPT write this entire thing. So, We're going to see how it goes. I can't cite anything, but let's get going. Before we get going, I'm sorry. Graduates, if you can please take out your phones, and if you reach under your seat, you'll find a black zipper pouch. If you could please put your phones, put them in the zipper pouch and leave them up front where I can see them, please. And I have an extra if somebody forgot theirs. Anyway, I want to share a story with you tonight. When I heard the theme, Dreamer, Builder, Explorer, it reminded me of a story I heard. I read about this in an education journal somewhere. And one time there was a school district several years ago, about 10 years ago, and for their convocation, their opening day for teachers, they brought in the CEO of a very famous ice cream company, one that you would all hear of. Clearly a school district that has more money than we do. He was a self-made millionaire. He came from very humble beginnings and had a really inspiring story to tell. And they thought, well, this will be a great story to energize the staff. And the CEO came up on a stage similar to this, talked to people that didn't want to hear what he had to say, similar to this. And he told a story about how in his ice cream, he used only the finest ingredients. They would travel the world to find the best of everything. And that's what made his ice cream so good. And he talked specifically about blueberries. And each and every one of you tonight is like a blueberry. And he went on, and he talked about the finest blueberries. They were plump. They were just ripe enough. They were juicy. You bit into them in the ice cream, and you could taste the delicious blueberry goodness. And when he was done, in the back, he saw a hand go up, and there was a seasoned teacher sitting in the back, and he saw the question. He was very excited. He said, yes, ma'am, question. She said, with all due respect, sir, you get to choose your blueberries. You get to pick the bluest ones, the plumpest, the juiciest, the ones that make the best ice cream. But sir, I don't have a choice in the blueberries I get for my ice cream. I get the blueberries that are given to me. Some of them are ripe and plump. Some of them are shriveled. Some of them are not ready to be used yet. They're still a little green. But I take all those blueberries and I do what I can year after year to make the finest ice cream. And immediately the CEO was struck and realized what had happened to them. And that's each and every one of you being a blueberry. You came to Freedom, or you came to the BASD 13 years ago. You weren't sure what you were doing. Some of you were ready and eager and running off the school bus, and some of you were picked up and shoved on the bus and your parents ran away while you were crying, or some of you don't even know how you got there. But the point is, you sit here tonight all different, all unique, all individuals, but all coming from the same place, the same bush. And Freedom and the Freedom family is what kind of molded you and helped you ripen into what you are today, ready to go out in the world. And that's what Freedom does. It brings people together in their unique individuality, and we celebrate that here. We celebrate our diversity, and what makes us different is what brings us together. And your class is certainly unique. You are one that has persevered through things that no class should have to go through. Freshman year, March 13th, 2020, the world seemingly ended. Walked out the door on a Friday, hey, we got 2 weeks off, and then thought, oh my gosh, are we ever gonna come back? But you did make it back to Freedom the next year, hybrid, masks, and that went on for a whole year. And then you came back your junior year, it's gonna be different, you still had masks on for a while. And then finally, by your senior year, you were ripe and ready to flourish and really take Freedom by the horns. And I understand you did a good job of that. You were so excited to be back. There was someone who was running around in a banana costume on a regular basis. There were teachers handing out mac and cheese Cheetos. Anything but a backpack day. There was a kid literally with a hand truck and a sandbox on wheels. So you certainly took all those 3 years pent up and brought them out this year. On the sports field, once again, you dominated. Boys lacrosse, 2 years in a row, district champions. Noah Potts, third consecutive District 11 singles title in tennis. CJ Horvath, district wrestling title. Yep. Of course, the first ever girls wrestling club, now team. Boys lacrosse, rifle, cheerleading, all qualified for state playoffs. The football team finished 10-3, reached the district final, and ended the season ranked number 7th in the state. Nick Ellis became the boys' basketball all-time leading scorer and rebounder, even even made Mr. Stellato speechless. It was such an incredible feat, if you can believe that. Krish Patel, Julia Heinemann, and Alex Hume all were named EPC Overall Scholar Athletes. However, this is all in the past. That time has come and that time has gone, and now it's time to move on and make your impact. As you enter a world that's constantly evolving, you will undoubtedly face uncertainties and obstacles, but remember this, with every challenge, there lies an opportunity for growth and self-discovery. Embrace the unknown with a sense of curiosity and an open mind. Embrace failure as a stepping stone towards success. Embrace setbacks as valuable lessons that will propel you forward. Your journey will not always be easy, but the challenges you encounter will shape you into resilient and compassionate individuals. Remember that the true measure of success lies not only in personal achievement, but also in how you contribute to the well-being of others and the betterment of society. Do not underestimate the power of your actions, no matter how small they may seem. Acts of kindness, of empathy and understanding have the potential to create ripples of change that can transform lives. Embrace diversity and inclusivity, for it is through embracing our differences that we foster a world that celebrates the richness of the human experience. Graduates, as you forge ahead, stay connected to your roots and the values that have shaped your journey thus far. Remember the teachers, the mentors, the friends who have supported you and guided you. Always cherish the memories that you have made with these within these walls at Freedom, and carry them with you as a source of inspiration and strength. Class of 2023, you are the architects of your own destiny, the dreamers, the builders, the explorers. Embrace the opportunities that lie ahead with courage, tenacity, and a sense of purpose. Pursue your passions, follow your dreams, and never lose sight of your true potential. Believe in yourselves, for you possess the power to create a brighter future, not only for yourselves, but for generations to come. And as you leave the confines of your school in this arena tonight, know that you carry with you our unwavering support and belief and pride. Congratulations, class of 2023. I want to leave you with the words of the late Chadwick Boseman, who said, "Whatever you choose for a career path, remember that the struggles along the way are only meant to shape you for your purpose. You already have everything inside you that you need to be successful. Now go out there and get it." Now, for what you've really been waiting for, I'd like to call on your class president, Prajit Santra, to join me at the podium to receive the first diploma of the class of 2023. Prajit, by the power vested in me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the Department of Education, having been duly certified by Ms. Sage and Dr. Roy to have met all the graduation requirements, I hereby declare you, the Freedom High School class of 2023, to be graduated. Congratulations.
We're almost at the end, guys. Don't worry. We're almost there. All right. Mr. Fascinetto, Dr. Roy, members of the Board of School Directors, Ms. Sage, platform guests, faculty members, parents and friends, and fellow members of the class of 2023. I like to think of our high school journey as that of climbing a mountain. As freshmen, I don't think that anybody could have predicted what we as a class would have to struggle through in order to arrive to this day. We prepared ourselves for a tough climb, but we were met with many challenges that hindered our progress. We have battled these challenges together as a class and individually to meet our goals. I was an online student for the majority of our sophomore year, and I struggled to adjust at first. The only time that I met with my teachers was on Mondays, and the short 30-minute Zooms left me feeling quite overwhelmed with all of the work I would have to complete throughout the week. I had to develop strong study habits, personal accountability, and discipline. I vividly remember my classmates and I being on FaceTime until 12 a.m. trying to figure out how to do the honors pre-calc homework. It fell more on us as a class and individuals to complete our work and to have the drive to achieve something greater. All of you sitting in front of me today were able to climb past those challenges by taking charge of your learning. No matter how many times your hands lost grip of the mountain, you were all able to catch yourselves and continue the climb. Our junior year started the return to a more normal life, but this was a new normal that we were entering. The peak of the mountain was in sight, but the usual climbing route was not functional. Everything was done on the Chromebooks while we were online and hybrid, so coming back into school and using paper and pencil was a shock in itself. I remember being in AP language and composition, and my hands started cramping after writing just one rhetorical analysis. Our lives outside of the classroom changed as well. The return to being able to play sports in front of crowds was monumental. The feeling of the riot squad roaring as we ran onto the field was like no other. Theater, chorus, and band were also able to enjoy being able to perform in front of others to share their wonderful productions. The climbing route classes before us traversed was blocked by an avalanche, and we, as a class, had to forge our own path. Now, as we have finally reached the peak of the mountain as seniors, I want you to reflect on your journey to the summit as we finally begin our descent. Thank the teachers who gave you the helmet, carabiniers, sling, ice axe, and harness as you climbed this mountain. Hold close the friends and family who helped you to not stray from the path, and cherish every moment that you have with them. I would like to take this moment to personally thank my parents and my sister for always being my number one supporters. I would also like to extend a special thanks to Mr. Young, Mrs. Sheets, Ms. Ruggiero, Dr. Krieger, Ms. Sage, and last and definitely not least, Coach Roeder, for helping to shape me as an individual in and out of the classroom. As we graduate, we reach an apex. However, that does not mean that it will be the peak of our life. It shouldn't be. For many of us, this mountain of high school will pale in comparison to the ones that we will have to climb in our futures. Whether that means going into college, the military, trade school, or the workforce, this is the point where we as a class will diverge into our own separate futures to explore what the world has in store for us. We have all proven that we are hard workers, determined to reach our peak, and I now challenge you to fight even harder to reach the peak of your next mountain. There are also going to be some of us who aren't sure what we want to do after high school, and that's okay. Make sure you keep goals for yourself, and then, even if you wander off the expected path of your future, you will never truly become lost. As J. Rould reflected, we, the class of 2023, are dreamers. Dream so big that it scares you. Dream so big that you stay up at night thinking about how you're going to reach the top of whichever mountain you choose to climb next. As Lauren reminded us, we, the class of 2023, are builders. Build up the tools you need for your next climb. Build strong relationships to make the climb easier. And finally, We, the class of 2023, are explorers. Explore the different paths available to you in the future. Explore your opportunities and make the most out of them. We traversed this new path of high school and paved the way for those after us. We will continue to dream, build, and explore as we all begin the climb of our next mountain. Class of 2023, congratulations. All right, everyone, class of 2023, you may now move your tassel from right to left to signify our graduation. We did it.
It is the time we have been waiting for. I am going to introduce Mrs. Amanda Miranda, who will begin with the recognition of the Lamp of Knowledge recipients. As your son or daughter's name is called, please watch for the accompanying slide. Not sure which TV it's coming on, but there's going to be an accompanying slide with all of your son or daughter's information.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great privilege to present the recipients of the Freedom High School Lamp of Knowledge. This distinguished honor is awarded to students who earn an A or A equivalent in every course of their high school career. Patience Asikwa Adodwaji. John Assad. Rachel Baffour. Victoria Balboni. Joseph Bauer. Azriel Burnett. Cesar Canales. Arun Chagani. Brianna Cole. John Coulter. Tiana Dalpezzo. Omar El Husseini. Braden Erker. Jackson Luther Eshba. Cameron Ryan France. Caitlin Geider. Jasmine Gibbons. Julia Griffith. Nilansh Gupta. Julia Heineman. Madison Paige Horvath. Lauren Elizabeth Humphrey. Michaela Mary Rose Kirby. Krishna Korapati. Aaron Kraus. Kyle W. Coleman. Jairo Joseph Lazo Ayala. Colin James Lutz. Tyler J. Malitsky. Ashley McElroy. Krish Patel. Taylor Pavelko. Noah Potts. Jerry A. Rivera. John E. Roeder. Alec John Rubery. Mary Jo Rutkowski. Amelia Saggio. Prajit Santra. Reagan Olivia Schaefer. Kayla M. Schenkel. Tyler T. Smith. Kane Stoffer. Nathan C. Suleiman. Ann T. Sweeney. Sophia Trembler. Molly O'Connell Twigger. Gerald Aldwin Ramirez Veneracion. Ella Walker. Sophia Walker. Tristan Willie. Willie Yang. This concludes our Lamp of Knowledge recipients. At this time, I ask Dr. Roy and Mr. Josh Tahanica to join me at the podium for a special announcement. Moravian University partners with the Bethlehem Area School District to give 1 4-year full tuition scholarship to a Freedom High School graduating senior. The 2023 Superintendent's Moravian University Scholarship recipient is Melanie Ann Nonemaker.
Asaf Akbash. Angel Julian Alamo. Amelia Marie Altimos. Jamel Alvarez. Sophie D. Amatori. Olivia Anders. Angelica Rose Frianila Aquino. John Adet. Amy Badman. Kai Lucas Baker. Jake A. Ballerini. Prisha Banerjee. Joseph Barbosa. Mark Anthony Mead Barger. Jenna Marlene Barton. Sarah Angela Batelli. Juliana Catherine Beck. Angeles Georgina Vincent Martinez. Mohamed Berziz. Adam L. Billard. Zane G. Billard. Caitlin Joan Baburka. Jacob Boger. Chase I. Bonstein. Steven Boshnikov. Peyton S. Bozick. Eleftheria Bozikis. Jandiel Ariel Brazoban. Nailise Monique Brown. Layla Ashley Browning. Samia A. Bryant. Jameson Jeffrey Calixto. Paola C. Casillas Figueroa. Hugo Andres Castro Martinez. Jaslyn Cedeño. Dulce Chinchilla Girón. Rohit Chinawar. Jasmine S. Chu. Madeline Cole. Talon M. Collins. Abigail Sara Colon. Jaylene Colon. Malachi Josiah Conaway. Madeline Grace Cooper. Elise Corallo. Raina Michelle Costa. Siani C. Cotto. Caden Creamer. Shannon Elise Criollo. Coco Crisafulli. Ashley Marie Cruz. Isabel Lee Cruz. Keswick Joel Cruz Salgado. Tyler C. Seapoff. Michael De La Nuez. Javier De Leon Andino. Andrew R. DeAngelis. Tristan Patrick DeFrancesco. Amanda Cristina Delgado. Liam Patrick Dennis. Emily Dino Ryan. Isabel DiPietro. Joseph M. Dew. J. Shania Elise Diaz. Owen DeNapoli Anicarico. Tatiana Belen Dos Santos. Bernard Marcus DeMond. Devin Carter DeMond. Braden Kyle Drust. Jay Shalee Paris DuPont. Morgan Zakayla Dyer. Nina Maria Ziyak. Anna Marie Echevarria. Hermelina Sevilla Edrada. Corey A. Elliott. Kayshawn Amir Ellis. Nicholas Ellis.
Batter El Sayed Goeyed. Mitat Etka Averlu. Kevin Antonio Estrada. Sean A. Etheridge. Nicholas A. Farrell. Griffin Thomas Farrell. Edwin Fehu II. Jenna M. Feldman. Kate E. Feldman. Joel Emmanuel Figueroa. Jalen M. Fletcher. Candy Florentino. Enrique Flores Reyes. Jasnelli Mireya Florian Lucho. Tyler Joseph Forney. Zachary T. Franges. Tyler Brian Frankenfield. Arlen Natalia Fries. Patrick Edward Valentine Bean Paul. Ronald Gaffney IV. Hannah Marie Gallagher. Liliana Game. Anaya J. Garcia. Anais Marie Garcia Ruiz. Katiushka Jomaris Garcia Ruiz. Tyler Jacob Giamoni. Kelly Gill. Colin Peter Gonzalez. Efrain Gonzalez Roman. Jacob T. Grillo. Xavier Grunstra. Julia Marie Hamm. Mikayla Rose Harka. Calvin Michael Harriman. Faraz Hassan. Ryan James Hathaway. Lillian M. Hersick. Maria Celeste Hernandez Martinez. Giovanni Hernandez Perez. Haley E. Hirschbeck. Mylin Juan. Tulin Wong. Ryan Hoffman. Tristan Hoffman. Emily Hope Hajnowski. Christian Horvath. William J. Hoy. Joshua C. Huber. Amaria Humphrey. Aliana Yasira Hunt. Omar Saliam Hunter. Maya Ijeskas. Tenley Marie Ear. Paige Morgan Jenkins. Charlize Johnson. Nathaniel Matthew Johnson Jr. Kiana Elise Johnson. Kyle Johnson. Owen Johnson. Peyton S. Jones. Ben Isaac Joseph. Grace Catherine Joseph. Brianna Kelly. Angelina Jolie Kemmerer. Jason Kirk. Taras N. Kohut. Ava Nicole Kulishenko. Kevin R. Coleman. Brooke Ilona Corona. Gavin B. Labadia. Nathaniel Lambert. Stephanie Carolina Laura De La Hoz. Sarah D. LaRiviere. Sophia Lavin. Anastasia Lady. Bradley David Lee. Dominic Jason Leininger. Serenity Rose Leon. Aaron J. Levy. Troy M. Levy. Alexis Luter.
All right. We are going to pause for just 1 minute. Tonight, we are taking a moment to remember a member of the class of 2023 who just passed away in April. A seat has been saved on the floor for Kevin Liriano, who would have been here tonight. Prior to his death, he had been pursuing a career in nursing. Tonight, his family is here with us, and his brother Carlos will be coming to stage to accept Kevin's diploma in his honor. The class of 2023. to the family of Kevin, the class of 2023, and the Freedom family sends our deepest sympathies. We thank you for coming tonight. At this point, we will continue with our reading of the names.
Nasir T. Lowry Baker. Owen M. Lynn. Allison Lynn Makula. Anthony Rafael Manana. Krishna R. Mangro, Jr. Jayla A. Marrero. Dayanara L. Marrero Allen. Zara I. Martin. Caden Sierra Martinez. Annalise Martinez Bonaparte. Melvin A. Matos. Nyla Najaya Mayo. Michelle Hassana McKenzie. Isaiah Rose McKinnon. Thanaporn Mijinda. Damian Jose Mejia Ta. Nagalis Mejias. Isalis Mejias Berrios. Natalie Merced. Anthony Seth Michael. Jonier Josue Mikolta. Caleb Miller. Rihanna Mitchell. Cooper Mitcheltree. Nathan Moore. Jasmine Morales Lopez. Evan James Moritz. Andrew Morgan. Jaque Zaire Morles. Christian Luis Morat. Julie Mortman. Justin Tyler Moyer. Elias Malero. Dylan Muller. Danielle Nicole Neely. Ethan Neidig. Sarah Ashley Nelson. Jasmine Victoria Nepomuceno. Ella Michelle Nesvetter.
Rayshawn Anthony Nicholas. Luis Xavier Nieves. Jenna B. Adote. Janali Michelle Oliveira Rodriguez. Sven Alexander Enrique Orachevsky. Michael Aracio Jr. Dayanara Ivelis Orjuela. Darian Xavier Orta. Isaac Emilio Ortega. Adangelis Ortiz Torres. Iris Devana Otero. Brian David Pabon. Carrie Ellis Marie Pacheco. Leslie Padilla. Madiana Paxos. Michele Coelho Paez. Monet Elise Paisho. Shaylenice Perez Mendez. Jacob Omar Perez Rodriguez. Josiah G. Peters. Jordan Rebecca Phillips. Gage Pison. Thomas Matthew Pierapavel. Maria D. Polanco. Lucas Poplowski. Joseph A. Potenza. Lillian Elisa Potter. Megan Ruffino. Ziad Ahmed Raghab. Oscar Ramirez. Patrice Victoria Rhodes Thompson. Nailani Elizabeth Ricketts. Amaya Lene Riddick. Justin Manuel Rios Ramos. Javier De Jesus Rivera III. Naomi Star Rivera. Sanaya Maribel Rivera. Giovanni Nicole Rivera Ortiz. Joel Alexis Rivera Pizarro. Dianeris N. Rivera Rosario.
Donovan Robertson. Casey Anita Robertson. Lana Stephanie Rodriguez Brass. Brianna Nadine Rodriguez. Christian Elijah Rodriguez. Dominic Jaden Rodriguez. Elijah Edwin Rodriguez. Giovanni Rodriguez. Kaylee Victoria Rodriguez. Shaylimar Rodriguez. Steven N. Rodriguez. Samantha Nicole Rodriguez Rosales. Elise Rode. Juan J. Roman Mendez. Briseis Aylin Rosado. Zanaya Alizela Rosado. Lucius Rosado Stoll. Wyatt Rosario. Logan Royella. Soraya Ruiz. Ryan Rummel. Kayla Ann Russell. Tegan F. Ryan. Dylan J. Saw. Neil Suchdeva. Samaj Sailor. Isabella Salicetti. Haded Latifa Sanchez Mora. Ava Isabel Sandoval. Gavin F. Sant. Alexi Sangster Jr. River J. Leandro Santana. Hemelin Caroline Santana Hibeiro. Alexis Michael Santiago. Antonio Santiago. Benjamin Santiago. Karimar Santiago. Alexa Jamilet Santiago Batista. Isabella Rose Schaefer. Catherine Jean Schiffer. Kaylin Madison Schoenberger. Derek Schroyer. Imogen Rogue Cephas. Abigail Lynn Schenkweiler. Malik Sharif. Trinity Shope. Olivia Serenchinsky. Fabian Andre Sierra Torres. Aiden Joshua Sigley Hicks. Amanda R. Simpson. Kayla Ann Singley. Vincent Michael Slepitz Jr. Jason Smith. Wesley Tahir Smith. Marcus Vinicius Suarez Travassos. Jaden Sullivan. Anthony R. Sadler. Brooklyn Marie Spence. Dominic Peter Sportelli IV. Morgan Louise Springer. Ava Christine Stekowitz. Keturah Marissa Stewart. Maya Catherine Stickler. Connor John Stefanik. Julia Marie Stefanik. Olivia K. Stroll. Jada C. Dominique Suarez. Peyton Hona Taylor. Paige M. Teletovich. Jaden Joel Tillett. Jovanka Arine Tirado Cardona. Mariah Amarin Titus. Samantha E. Turok. Natalie Toth. Jalen Mercedes Trinidad. Adriana Jatam Trumbauer. Miles Bradford Turner. Ashley Nicole Ulmer. Devin Elise Ulmer. Jackson William Valish.
Catherine Gazelle Valladares Oriana. Trent Andrew Vandeveer. Ramon Marcela Vasquez Jr. Cameron Thomas Vaughn. Daniel Vega. Misael Vega. Tyler Joseph Wadsworth. Jolene Waba. Nicholas Kyle Walter. Gabriella Silva Warren. Isabella Weaver. Nicole Weppel. Elijah A. White. Cameron Wickemeyer. Jaden Jaleel Wilson. Ryan Woolley. Aubrey Yeager. Tess Salutsky. Daniel Suck. and Stephanie Joanne Zuniga. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that we present to you the Freedom High School Class of 2023.
Next, I would like to bring to the podium the officers for National Honor Society for the presentation of their gifts, Jasmine Gibbons, Omar El Husseini, Reagan Schaefer, Julia Heineman, and Jasnelli Florian.
Good evening, faculty, staff, family, friends, and fellow graduates of the class of 2023. My name is Jasnelli Florian, and I am the NHS historian. For our class gift, the Freedom High School National Honor Society class of 2023 has started a new annual tradition and donated $1,000 to the creation of the Altruism Award. The award recognizes four members of the graduating class who embody the pillars of NHS: scholarship, service, leadership, and character. Tonight, we would like to announce the four recipients of the first annual Altruism Award. As we announce your name, please stand and be recognized.
The recipient of the Altruism Award for leadership is Madison Horvath.
The recipient of the Altruism Award for Scholarship is Willie Yang.
The recipient of the Altruism Award for Service is Patience Adedowaji.
The recipient of the Altruism Award for Character is Cameron France.
Congratulations to all our recipients.
Next, I want to bring to the stage the senior class officers to present the class gift. Please come to the stage, Prajeet Santra, Lillian Hersick, Elise Corallo, and Madison Horvath.
Hello, my name is Lily Hersick, and I will be presenting the class gift. On behalf of the class of 2023, we have chosen to gift a Patriot mascot to the current and future students of Freedom High School to carry on the never-ending school spirit of the class of 2023.
Next, I would like to take a moment to recognize any of our graduates who have obtained Eagle Scout. We have four members of the class of 2023 who have obtained this honor. Please rise. Thank you. I now turn it over to Mr. Moran and Mr. Lin, who will be recognizing members who are enlisting or are enlisted in the armed forces.
Thank you.
recognizing the graduates going into the armed services and also those present who are or were members of the armed forces. Please rise when your service branch song is played. Army. Navy. Air Force. Marines. Coast Guard.
I now ask you to look at the projectors around the auditorium and enjoy the senior video.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. When the moment comes, you'll say.
In that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave, I just wanted my name in a star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe. Someday these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon you'll holler.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through, that I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place.
Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last
it's
ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
All right, as we come to a conclusion, one final time, Prajit Santra.
As we end today, I would like to leave you with one last quote from David Goggins. When you are driven, whatever is in front of you will get destroyed. Class of 2023, remember to always dream, build, and explore as we continue our futures. Everyone, congratulations, class of 2023. We did it! We'll be right back.